was thinking, like, of Victor. Like, how good would be he a replacement in the Pharaoh deck? Like, I have an idea. Like, he'll be creating a discard fodder. We could justify running Get Excited in the deck with Victor. We cut Ezreal, and we cut something. We could cut, like, something else to make space for Get Excited as well. Because we could. With Victor, we would have enough discard fodders. Problem with Oh, I know what I would be cutting. I would be cutting Static Shock as well, because we don't need to flip Ezreal anymore. I would cut Static Shock. Like, I would cut cards that are slowing out your tempo, which is Static Shock and Ezreal. Those are like tempo killers in your in the deck. And I just would go full tempo with Victor and Get Excited. Just push early damage and finish with Get Excited or Pharaon and Mystic Shots. Alright. No music? The music, man. Yo, another Freddy. Wait, we were right about the Freddy or the landmark. Hold on, what was the play? I want to read the text. 8 drop. Eat that stairs. What the fuck is this name? Eat that stairs. Shiku got a brother. Shiku got a brother. Obliterate all landmarks or deal 2 to other units. Oh wow. You can deny this as well. Oh wow. Obliterate all landmarks or deal 2 to all other units. It damages your own board. It's like it's like Avalanche. So this is 4 mana. Like sometimes it'd be just 4 mana. 8-8, right? Like card that's a big unit and comes with removal. Very good. The problem is card doesn't have overwhelm or anything to like push through damage. But having that flexibility in the deck to have the landmark removal also is nice if them landmarks becomes the meta. Yeah, definitely one off in the decks. At least, well, yeah, it's so flexible you can afford to run at least one off. Yeah, you obliterate your own landmarks as well. Okay, the Scar grants landmark. When an ally survives damage, granted +1/+0 and Van Tuff. I mean, how much more damage you're gonna bring for Vlad? Guys, we have to just accept. Vlad is not good. And you put it in Freljord, so you have to match Freljord with Vlad. Just accept it, Vlad suck. Yeah, you curve into Braum, like you turn 3 Scargrounds, turn 4 Braum. But then, opponent, like let's assume opponent played 2 drop, then they played 3 drop. Like let's assume opponent played like House Spider into Draven. They attacked on 2, so they push like you are at 17. And they are open attacking on 4. You are looking at... they are pushing another 6, so you're at 11, you develop Braum. You can't even develop Braum if you don't have combat trick, because they just beam it. They have then 5 mana for a beam. Yeah, and then you like, if you don't have combat trick, you are just praying, hey, they have no beam. It's slightly too slow against mid-range decks. You have to drop Vow. Yeah, but then you cannot drop Braum because you have no combat trick to protect it. Most of the time. You will need to play Elixir of Iron to be able to run 2 drop. It will be good against... like, look at this card and imagine you play against Gohard. This card just... like... They might not nerf the Gohard because there are many ways to deal with Gohard. Like, Freljord just got this. Like, this landmark is great against Gohard. The Eat That Stairs is great against Gohard, because you just play, if they go pack your bags, you just jump her and you remove their entire board and they have no swing. Yeah. Oh, Ionia landmark. Create a sanctuary in hand. Okay, I was wrong, guys. I was expecting they'll make a landmark that after meeting certain condition, it will recall either your own or opponent's unit. Okay, but it's creating a card. Let's hope this card. I love them. Like, they listen to the feedback and they are not making expensive landmarks. Landmarks cannot be cannot cost more than 4 mana. Like, 3 is borderline what makes them playable. 4 would be probably too much already for most of them. But 3 and 2 is the, like, key cost for the landmarks. And I'm really happy they recognized it. Recall an ally. Oh, I was partially right. Burst. Problem is it's fleeting, right? Yeah, it's fleeting. Can't be cast in combat or in response to a spell. There, like, we need to see more cards. Like, there is probably some combo coming that we cannot see. They need to reveal more cards, I would assume. Like, right now, without seeing all the cards, I would straight up, it's a garbage. So, like, they could be thinking about, like, Elder. Mentor. And Jewel Protector. And Concussive Palm. And that's about it, about the synergy. Like, the problem with this card would be not bad. Like, this would be actually a very nice card if you could play it. If it would be fast and you could. Yeah. Play it. I mean, it's a burst. It can't be. Yeah, disrupted. I mean, I guess we could use this to. But the opponent can see that and they'll never play into the recall plus Yasu plus Yone. I mean, okay, the one massive value I can see, like, Spacey Sketcher with this is massive, because you have this card fodder, and then next turn you can recall her, and then turn after you can just keep playing her. Like, it's super nice with Spacey. Alright. Recall an ally unit or landmark to recall an enemy unit or landmark. Worse Wheel of Ionia? I disagree. I think it's better than Wheel. In certain decks. Like, it's definitely like one-off card, like one-off. Most of the time you won't be playing more of this. Like, the reason why it's decent... Like, how often you had situation where you had to decide, you either save your own unit with Will, or you recall opponent's unit, right? And this card is exactly what it connects both, because you can save your unit and remove your opponent threat from the board at the same time. Like, let's assume... You have opponents develop Tryndamere on board, you develop Karma, next turn they open attack, you palm, they vengeance your Karma, and then you play Homecoming, you not only save your Karma, but also you remove your opponent Tryndamere from the board. At once. Really good tempo swing. Like, we need to see more, like, you can see here, like, this card, and this card. Like, you need some good play effect cards for it worth to be recalling. I'm pretty sure they gonna introduce some cards that possibly buff your entire deck that you can recall. Do you have anything else? With a Bilgewater Follower. 3-1. 6 mana. Reduce my cost by 1 for each spell you've cast this game. When I'm summoned, create a 1 cost spell from your regions. In hand. Guys, this is the card made for this deck. This is literally to make Mind Melt better. One more card. Alright, let's see.
Oh shit!
I'm thinking of a way to make this decent. I can't. It went early. Alright, let's see. Victor Bradley! That's not a good link. Alright, let's have it. Fuck off, Victor. I've seen it coming though. I've seen in the link Victor Bradley. You didn't debate me. Oh wait, there is no music in this. The Grand Plaza. Landmark. When a, 3 mana, good cost. When an ally is summoned, give it +1/+1 and challenger this round. Actually, not bad. Actually, not bad. Like this, this is the perfect card for the dragons. Like, there is not much to talk about here. It's the Masha card. You are just supposed to curve out after this. But yeah, it's pretty good. Also, this. Oh my fucking god. This with Undying? Yikes! Captain Arika, Elite. 8 mana, 6/6. Play. Capture a unit or landmark. Spell Shield. It's 8 mana, it's trash. Guys, it has. You are getting Detain and a 6/6 body with Spell Shield. It's a 6/6 body Spell Shield with Detain. This is very good card to get from Lancer. Like, it's a one-off into the decks, certain decks, right? Like, you guys underestimate how much you need landmark removal. Like, there will be crazy decks. Nice Astro. There will be crazy decks with the PNZ landmark. They just gonna be... You won't be able to push through them. You will be need... Ah, but it's 8. Remove the landmark. Like, even if you remove a landmark, like, it's still 5 mana. You remove 3 mana, you still get 5 mana of a Worf stats unit. I mean, this is crazy good. Like, you can remove any unit on board you need, or you can play around, like, Ruination with this card as well. I love this card. Very, very nice card. Like, the fact it has Spell Shield is fucking massive. Like, you need to commit so many resources to kill this. We are getting 2 mana, 2/2. Ephemeral, Fearsome, cannot block. Nightfall, create a copy of me in hand. Pesky Spectre, 0 mana, 1/1. Last Breath, create 2 copies of me in the enemy deck. Oh! Yeah, I know when it feels. Why for Karma? Because you often, like late game, you struggle with the hand size. And early game, you want cheap blockers on the opponent's attacking. Like, you can play it after, like, the biggest thing, you can play Ruination, they develop a unit, and you have a blocker for 0 mana. And late game, you don't care if they put it in your deck, because you want to draw, actually, 0 mana cards to make hand space. Like, this is perfect card for the Spooky Karma. I would play 3 of this instead of Hapless, 100%. Moonlight Affliction, 5 mana Fair Burst Targon spell. Silence 2 enemy units this round. Nightfall, they cannot block this round. Like, the silence most of the time won't matter. The Nightfall is kinda interesting. Like, the silence won't matter. The silence part is actually like eh. The cannot block is interesting. You need to play one card into this card. Like, you need to play like a one drop into this and open attack. It's quite strong for like curve out decks early drops. Also, you could play something like it could be a finisher for decks like Leona Invoke deck, where you play like Moonlight into this, and then you like removed 4 blockers for opponent. Like, this would be one of in some decks. Solari Sunforger, Daybreak, give me lifesteal this round. 4 mana, 5/4. Now this is a card. Exactly. This is better lifesteal girl. Like, guys, you don't realize you play, like, imagine you play a landmark into this card. You have 6/5 challenger with lifesteal. On attack, on turn 4. And you can play back-to-back this card into Radiant Guardian. It has already good stats, and on top of that you can get lifesteal. Like, guys, it trades with the 5 drops, it's very good. Yeah, BBG will... this is BBG's boyfriend now. Radiant Guardian, step aside. Let's check last card and I need to use bathroom. Targon's Peak, Landmark, Run Start, 5 mana. Ooh, hate 5 mana Landmark. Runstar, reduce the cost of the random card in each player's hand to 0. Oh my god, meme fiesta. Meme fucking fiesta. I'm gonna go to toilet. Guys, you can talk about this card. Fuck. Guys, you guys think already Sky's Descent on 6? Like, you, like opponents develop the board and out of nowhere you get Sky's Descent on 6. And yeah, just go next. Alright, Zoe! Oh, fuck off. 1-1, elusive. Timo Grill. Nexus Strike. Create a super cool star chart in your hand, or if you have one, reduce its cost by one. Level up. If I've seen you play 10 cards with different names. Okay, level up is like impossible. Level up is like literally impossible. You need her on board and play 10 cards. Not your business, you cringe. Super cool star chat. Burst, invoke a celestial card that costs 3 or less. Oh shit. Actually, not bad. Actually, not bad. Damn. Puddle Star. 3 mana. Deal 4 to an enemy. To an enemy that attacked this round or is stunned. Guys. That attacked this round or is stunned. Slow. Yeah, 3 mana flock. 3 mana flock. I mean, the good part about this card. Actually, this is gonna be buffing Tribeam. I like the fact that this buffs Tribeam. And it's a like decent removal. Like, as a Targon, you can play with your HP, you can soak HP, right? Like, if you deal, like, this is a good card, guys. Like, you want to, like, as Targon, you don't care often if you soak the damage, and you just use this without a flock condition. Like, I would say this is, yeah, I think it could be better than, actually, it could be better than the flock. Like, overall, good card. You're gonna be playing this with, like, star shaping and etc., right? Guiding touches. But overall, a solid card. I like it. Slow? Doesn't matter it's slow. You're gonna be playing it after combat phase. Like, it literally doesn't matter it's slow. Like, the only way it's gonna be mattering when you want to play it as a response to, like, single combat or concerted. But overall, you will be using that on the unit that is either stunned or already after combat. So, both cases, the unit needs to be on bench, right? You can't use it on the unit that would, like, even if it was fast, you wouldn't be able to use it on the board during the combat phase because of the conditions it needs to meet. Like, even if it's pairs, like, it doesn't matter because you can't use it on the unit that's in combat. Kabumi! Okay, dude. Kabumi. Spell Thief. Pick one of the 3 enemy spells played this game and create a copy in hand. We're gonna enjoy some Atrocity, Vengeance, even Ruination. Man, this card. Yeah, feel the rush. This card. Damn. Pack your bags? Yeah, imagine getting pack your. Wait, does it work with pack your bags? I wonder what's the interaction. But overall, Pog you card. If you think about it, like, this card will have always will always be bad in terms of tempo, because you're gonna need to play the card. You're gonna be able, like, you have to RNG the card you need, and you're gonna be paying one extra mana for it, right? Because bear, like, you have to pay one mana for spell thief. But the flexibility of this card pays it off, probably. Interesting. For the rest of the game, when you summon an ally, grant its keywords to all allies. Nexus Ray, create a behold the infinite that costs 0 in hand. Absolutely broken. Level up is broken, but she's so hard to flip that just, yeah. I mean, she's incredibly hard to flip, guys. You need to play, like, she needs to stick on board for for like 5-6 runs. Like, this is harder to flip than like TF. Wait, what was that? Man, the level up, though. Oh, the f- okay. Wait! Hold on. Am I tripping? I mean, this effect is not even that strong. Because the way you're gonna build the deck, you're gonna be having cheap-ass stuff. No, she's not trash. Like, she has the whole unique concept. But... like, it straight up depends on the meta. Like, if the meta will be slow enough, she could be good. Like, if the meta is, let's say, I don't know, Freljord Ionia, she's amazing. Right? If there is like Trindade, Trundle, Field Rush meta, then she's suddenly amazing. But if the meta is go hard, like, yeah, you can see the problem there. Okay, so Zoe's Sleepy Trouble. Oh, that's her special card. Interesting. Sleepy Trouble Bubble. Stun an enemy. Create a fleeting Puddle Star in the hand. Shuffle Zoe into the deck. Puddle Star. Wait, this card is crazy. This card... okay, actually, this card makes Yasuo viable. It is slow? Doesn't matter that it's slow. Like, this is exactly what I was talking about, that stun cards needs more value. Like, the reason why you can, like, you're gonna main deck those, like, even if you don't have Yasuo on board, you can play this, and then you can remove the unit. Like, you can pay 5 mana to remove 4 HP unit, that's not a bad trade. And on top of that, you can have a Yasuo interaction, right? Alright, and what else do we have? Starix Camp, I cost 2 less if you behold a Celestial. Oh, wow. That's a very... good tempo swing card. No, this is overall good. Like, even for the slower decks, this is good. Because it's like 0 mana to 2 blocker for free. Like, it will be very good for the Aesol even deck. Like, because you struggle with tempo. And Sparkle Fly, 1-2 elusive life steal. This card is very interesting. This is the card. I am thinking, like, how much Damasha will be. Like, if Damasha is not popular, elusive might come back. I mean, even if you force opponent to sharpside, it's not bad. Like, you force opponent to block Zoe with the sharpside, like, they won't have enough blockers. Yeah, you can make the elusive deck, like, easily. Like, yeah, elusive will make a comeback. Like, imagine you play against Damasha deck, that all they run is, like, single combat and sharpside. They didn't play any sharpside, and all you can yoink is a single combat. What do you do then? You have that card in your hand. Because your single combat in your deck is literally unusable. Single combat yoink still sounds quite good. And what, you're gonna combat your like 2-2? I mean, I prefer her way more than Fizz. Like, Fizz was like the meme card. Zoe is actually... you can make a really interesting decks around her. Fizz was like... yeah, Zoe will get flipped in the matchups where opponent only removal are heavy removal, like at least Avalanche Plus. Like, if opponent won't have good removals, or like if you're gonna be playing like if you combine her, like I'm thinking of playing Zoe with Karma and combining like you and only Ionia cards I would play would be Karma, Deny, Nopify, and all the early game and all the cycle plus Invoke cards. So you have late game secured with Karma, And early game, you have provided by Zoe. I think, like, Zoe Karma will be legit deck. Alright, I think 30 minutes milking is good enough, what do you think?